wrong with you?
Let's talk to our social media expert, Chris Dessi, this morning. What does it mean, Facebook, a billion people? Should we care?
It's a big milestone for Facebook. It is a billion. You know, like in the movie, The Social Network, they talk about, you want to know what's cool, not a million, a billion is cool. It's cool. It's a milestone. Unfortunately for Facebook, it hasn't helped their stock at all. A couple of weeks ago, they had an announcement where they were going to allow individuals to give actual gifts through Facebook. We saw a small spike on the stock. The billion, not so much. They have a new announcement where they're allowing individuals to pay for promoted posts on their Facebook page.
Oh, yeah. What about that? Because I've seen that on my page. Well, is it worth it to, like, pay?
You know, I don't love the energy behind it because, to me, it smacks of Facebook scampering to try and find revenue streams. They've already been allowing businesses to promote Facebook posts since May. I've used it for my own personal business page, and I haven't seen that much success. I've even blogged about some of the comments, and some of the individuals that are commenting on the paid posts weren't necessarily appropriate for the demographic that I was looking at. So they're kind of working out the kinks right now. I don't love that they're putting costs associated to individuals. I would be more okay with them saying, hey, you're a business and you have a Facebook page. Why not pay us in a continuity model, $7 a month, and we'll charge the business instead of the individual?
All right, Chris, you're a social media expert. The business model may still be off for Facebook, for stockholders, et cetera.
Yeah, yeah.
But the social model, the social impact is inarguable. How does something like this change a presidential election, a marketing campaign?
It's gasoline on the fire. I mean, the manner in which we aggregate and disseminate information as a culture has definitively changed. We can't say one thing on Facebook without it flashing across the screen for individuals that might potentially have 1,000 friends. So it's like getting on a phone call with 1,000 people immediately. There's an instantaneous reaction. Sometimes that's good. Sometimes that's not so good. Sometimes, you know, I made a joke yesterday on my own personal Facebook page, and I said, I hereby vow to not indicate any of my religious and or political proclivities. You know, go Yankees. And that was the only one that I kind of skewed toward because people get very heated and very emotional about these things.
You're right. Well, let's talk about what happened on Twitter.
Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Not the first time and not the last time it happened on Twitter. There was a brand that actually individuals were managing the brand on Twitter. You know, Silverback Social does that for brands. We tweet on behalf of specific brands. We do Facebook posts and Google Plus posts. And this is not unusual. What is unusual is that an individual that was managing this content actually posted a pretty horrible tweet that they thought was coming from their personal Twitter account.
Oh.
They mistook it and sent it out to the business Twitter account.
And now, basically it said Obama's grandmother even knew it was going to be bad. She died 3 days before he became president.
I mean,
so this guy wanted to do it from his personal account, but
which is horrible to begin with. Like, why would you do that from your personal account? And there are tools. I mean, we leverage tools like Hootsuite and TweetDeck to manage all the different brands that we're managing. It's never happened to us. But the thing is that you need to be able to curate your own content, understand where you're sending these messages, and that you are sending it on behalf of a brand. And there needs to be an overarching brand strategy. Chipotle ran into an incident like this a year ago, where somebody managing their Facebook account had actually run over a cat and posted something about running over the cat. Now, what happened was, within minutes, people flipped out about this. Animal rights activists flipped out about this, and they started creating Facebook pages counter to Chipotle, saying Chipotle serves cat meat. I mean, the implications are absolutely astronomical.
What people, I suppose, your message is, what people need to realize is, it's one click, it's one press. The difference between reply and reply all, or where you're posting, can be the difference of between being employed and being unemployed, and
expeditiously unemployed,
and being exiled.
Yeah, absolutely. It can be a tool for good, and you can put out great messages, and you can sing the praises of people. Brands can engage with consumers like they've never been able to engage before, and you can do some really great things in this world. But it can be it's a very delicate creature.
All right, Chris Dessi, thank you so much. What's the name of your company again?
Silverback Social.
All right, good to know.